My dear friend, in the previous talk, we reflected on what is your name? Name indicating the character of a person. And the purpose of giving a name to a person is the person may grow according to the expectation that comes from that particular name. Today in this number, I would like to reflect on another aspect of the life of John the Baptist, which we had been reflecting in the last two talks. Luke's Gospel, chapter 1, verse 80, which says, "And the child grew and became strong in spirit." So this is a summary explanation of the growth of John the Baptist. Welcome to RMC Bishop channel, and thank you for subscribing this channel and sharing it with others. Before going into the details of this particular topic, that is on the growth, let me also give you another two examples. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verse 52, it is said, "Jesus increased in wisdom and in stature and in favor with God and man." So how Jesus grew up is summarized in this particular verse, Luke 2:52. Now a third example I would like to show is from the book of Judges, chapter 13, verse 24, which summarizes about the growth of Samson. It is written, "The woman bore a son and called his son Samson, and the boy grew and the Lord blessed him." So in all these three examples of John the Baptist, of Jesus, and from the Old Testament Samson, the word that captures our attention is growth. Naturally, a boy or a child has to grow. But the question is, what should be the growth? In which direction it should be? Again, we have to come back to the basics. Man is composed of body and soul. So body has to grow. We call it human growth. Human growth is different from the growth of an animal. Please keep that in the mind. And the other one is soul. And naturally, it is a spiritual growth that we talk about. While explaining these issues, these matters, I would like to categorize them for our easy understanding. So the first thing I would like to speak about is the intellectual growth. When we speak about a human growth, it is not only it is not just a physical growth. We are talking about the growth of the intellect and will as well. So intellectual growth will mean association of the facts of life, and from there extracting or emerging wisdom. We cannot go one track. Rather, we need to see all sides of a reality and then associate with other realities and learn or decide in which way we have to act. So that is called acting wisely or acting prudently, or even in ordinary way, if we put that is common sense. So intellectual growth will require the growth of the common sense. The second aspect will be academic growth. Academic growth is intended for making a person eligible for any type of work. Any type of work. It is not necessary to limit it to university studies, but it has to be applied to any walk of life, any type of work. For example, it can be a farmer, an electrician, plumber, carpenter, a mason, a lawyer, a teacher, a doctor, an engineer, a constructor, a painter, an actor, a singer, a musician, a nurse, a driver, a mechanic, a tailor, etc. It can be anything, anything which will make a person eligible to do a work in a professional manner, in a sincere manner, with a completeness, not doing halfway and leaving it. So the academic growth should be understood in this manner of making a person eligible to do a work properly. The third aspect will be emotional growth. A child has to grow also emotionally. What do we mean by that? We have to face lot of facts of life, realities of life, and we need to respond to it in a responsible manner and in the proper manner, in the appropriate manner, etc. Just to give one example, a few examples of facts of life, like sorrow and joy. How do we respond to that? We should not collapse. These are facts of life. That should not, we should not become victims of these facts of life, realities of life. But rather, we must become master. There is a saying, if we don't master our emotions will master us. We have all kinds of emotions like anger, envy, revenge, joy, love. So many other emotions we can add to that. So how do we handle our emotions properly? So putting them in another categories, let me enumerate, like joy and sorrow, profit and loss. We may not have profit all the time. There will be losses. But how do we face them? Health and sickness. There is a saying, health can be appreciated only when sickness comes. Health and sleep can be appreciated only when it is interrupted. So these are facts of life. One should grow in such a way that he is able to tackle both health and sickness. Another category may be friendship and enmity. How do we face them? How do we handle them? So ultimately, what I would like to say is emotional growth will be to become a responsible person, growing responsibly, becoming a responsible person as a member of a family and society. I am not alone. There are other people, and my interaction, my relationship with other people will bring all these, and we need to grow knowing or training ourselves in handling these. The next aspect will be physical. When we speak about a physical, the first thing will be bodily growth. For the body to grow naturally, we have to eat and drink. We need exercise. So bodily growth will mean knowing what is good and harmful for body, what to consume and what not to consume. Another aspect will be of the same, connected with the body, will be dress. What type of a dress I am wearing? A person should grow in that knowledge. Is my dress modest? Or is it decent? Or is it indecent? Or is it vulgar? So a person should have the capacity to judge with regard to one's own dress. So care for the body will also mean medical care, taking regular exercises. So as the child is growing, he should be endowed with knowledge in this aspect as well. Now coming to the second part, is that is the soul. The spiritual responsibilities of a person in relationship with God. And if that relationship is broken, then how to reconcile with God? What are the steps to be taken? So this knowledge, spiritual knowledge, is required for spiritual responsibility, for spiritual growth. Spiritual responsibility will also mean responsibility towards the religious entity in which one is a member. So one person can be a member of a religious entity, but others may be members in other religious entities, and we are obliged to respect them, respect their faith. So that is also a part of the spiritual growth. So putting them all together, we can say that it is the meaning of growing strong. So all the three examples which I enumerated in the beginning, we will be able to find out the interplay of all these things. So putting them together, we can say that we are growing strong. So now the question is, now as you listened to this talk, please examine, are you a strong person? We say, sometimes we say, you know, so-and-so is very highly intellectual but emotionally very poor. So one aspect may be strong but other aspects may be weak. But that should not be the case. There should be a proportional and, if possible, equal growth in every aspect. Have I grown up like that? Never better late than never. So even now it is better for us to examine our own life. Sit quietly in a place and reflect on that and see which area we are weak, and that area we must make stronger. Our motto is rebuild my church again. Jesus said, rebuild my church again. We can rebuild the church only by rebuilding ourselves. When we become strong, our church also will be strong. And therefore, please share this talk with others. I need your help to reach this talk to others. So please help me. Now I am going to give you my blessing. Just now make an intention in your mind and believe that you are going to get what you are asking. Be specific, and what is urgent, please ask just now. And my blessing is going to help you to receive that blessing. Okay? So here we go. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, if you have time, please listen to one more talk. That's all for today, my dear friend. Thank you. God bless you. Yours sincerely, in the mission of the church, Bishop Frank Komolakil.